Welcome to this module on the role of kings in construction and the maintenance of temples in Mesopotamia. The kings or the victorious chiefs would send men out to fetch to get the fine stones or metals that for the benefit of God. As you can see the construction here, the different color stones that are used in the construction and that on the name of God. So they used to use these stones which are brought from far off places for the benefit of God and community, and they used to also maintain a good record of the distribution of the temple wealth in an efficient way, how the money is going in or the wealth is going in and how it is coming in. They used to maintain a good record of the accounts of the temple wealth. They used to send men to get precious stones for the benefit of God in the construction of the temples, and they would also maintain a good record of the temple wealth that is given by the chief or the king for the construction or beautification of the temple. Who were used in construction of the temple? The war captives and the local people were put to work for the temple or directly for the rule. So the people, those who were part of the soldiers of the defeated army, were taken as war captives, and the local people were together made to work for the construction of a temple or directly for the ruler. This, rather than an agricultural tax, it was compulsory that they have to work for the temple construction or for the ruler. And those who were put to work were paid ration, not in cash. They were paid ration so that they can get some amount of food for the work what they are doing. It has been estimated that 1,500 men worked for 10 years a day and 5 years to build. So how long it would take for construction of one temple? It would take people of 1,500 men for 10 hours a day. For how long they will work? For 365 into 5 years. That is 1,825 days they have to work, then only the temple is to finish. So it is a long process. Nearly for 5 years they have to work, and they need 1,500 men to work for 10 hours a day to complete one temple. So with the rulers commanding people to fetch stones, precious metals or ores, to come and make the bricks and lay the bricks for the temple, or else go to a distant country to fetch suitable materials. So there is a duty which is given to the men here. Either you work for the temple or you go for a distant place and get a valuable stone or a metal ore and contribute it in making the brick of the temple, so that that bricks can be used for construction of the temple. So in this module we learned who are working for the temple, who are brought to work in the temple. One, the war captives, the local people. They were not paid in cash. It is like a compulsory duty for them, and in return they used to get some amount of ration, some food for them, food grains or wheat grains for the work they are doing. It is estimated that for a construction of a temple it used to take 5 years with 1,500 men working 10 hours a day. So it is a very long process of construction of a temple. So men, either they have to work in the temple or they would go to a distant country or a place and fetch suitable materials and contribute in the construction of the temple. Hundreds of people were put to work at making and the baking of the clay cones that could be pushed into the temple walls, painted in different colors, creating colorful mosaic-like structures. So the people, those who went to the different places and who fetched the different stones or the metal ores from the distant countries that were used in making of the clay and lay in the bricks for the temple, why they want to make this? So the temple walls looked very beautiful and they painted in different colors for creating a colorful mosaic, as we can observe in this picture. That's all we have in this module. Stay tuned. We'll catch you in the next section.